Previously, we've been working with Bulk Candy Store to arm them with the tools to grow their business. In this video, we're going to do some preventative maintenance and focus on preventing a huge problem that a lot of growing merchants find themselves in by setting up sales tax automation and ensuring that the Bulk Candy Store's team doesn't get bogged down when the tax man comes calling. This is the eCommerce Makeover. Bulk Candy Store is growing, which means they're about to get to the size where their tax problems compound greatly. We need to dive more into how Ken is currently handling sales tax and make sure we have a process in place to keep this from becoming a big problem.
How well do you keep up with the evolving state sales tax laws?
We don't. At present, we charge people Florida sales tax. My mom, who does all her finances, has basically said if she has to start doing that, she's leaving.
We unfortunately are not tracking at all how close we are at hitting the thresholds in any of those states. We've been under the assumption that we haven't really done enough business to worry about it and kind of let it go. It's one of those things that would be nice if we did eventually, because the last thing we want is a sales tax audit. But at the moment, we kind of just take the risk.
You obviously have Nexus in Florida, so there's no other state that you currently have to deal with.
We only have Nexus in Florida. We have this one location. That's all right now.
I am concerned about not knowing when we reach Nexus in a state, because if we cross thresholds and don't collect sales tax, I suspect that we are subject to fines by the states.
How much time and energy does your current sales tax process take?
Because it's just Florida, it doesn't take a whole long time. It's a simple report we pull up on the website, we pull it up on our retail store, and boom, pay the sales tax. If you're asking what would happen if I had to do a bunch of others?
That's my next question.
That would be a lot of time. We have to run state by state. Did we meet the threshold? If we met the threshold, what's the tax rate? Do the tax rates vary by count? I don't know. I don't know any of that stuff. So I know it would be a big endeavor for us. And I don't want mom to quit, so it's something I really don't want to have to worry about.
I haven't done thorough research yet, but it's my belief that in the next 6 months to a year or so, we should be crossing some of the thresholds, especially the lower ones that some of those states have set.
It doesn't sound like sales tax is a big problem for Bulk Candy Store at the moment. However, each state has a different requirement for when you should start collecting and remitting tax to them. If we're successful in continuing their growth, they'll start crossing these thresholds pretty quickly. Before we get into the solution, if you want to learn more about how we're helping Bulk Candy Store grow, go to ecommercemakeover.com and download our free playbook on everything we're doing, including special offers on all the tools we'll be using, and be sure to subscribe to be notified each time we release new episodes. The only answer to sales tax compliance is automation. No one wants to do that by hand. I'm going to introduce Ken to Avalara to make sure these tax issues don't sneak up on him while he's busy focusing on all the shiny new things we're adding to the site.
I'm Jordan Carpenter. I'm with Avalara. We automate sales and use tax, along with a variety of other things around transactional tax.
Hey, Ken, how you doing?
Hi, Jordan.
Can you tell me a little bit more about your business, you know, how you're going to market now, how you're selling your items, and then also part of that, what platforms you guys are using for invoicing?
We have a retail store, plus we're online. Our online store is run through Magento One right now, but we're in the process of moving it to BigCommerce.
Are all of your sales in the U.S. currently, or do you ship overseas?
We ship primarily in the U.S., but we are open to shipping all over the world.
There's about 15,000 tax jurisdictions within the US. They all differ. They are not aligned to zip codes or postal codes, so not the easiest thing to track. And then also on the taxability front, you know, each of these taxing jurisdictions is allowed to make their own rules around how a product is taxed and if it's taxed at all.
Are you familiar with Economic Nexus?
No.
So a couple years back, mid-2018, there was a big Supreme Court ruling. It was Wayfair, the furniture company, versus the state of South Dakota. Supreme Court ruled in favor of South Dakota and said that states could set these economic nexus thresholds.
States have different thresholds, which then require out-of-state merchants to register and in turn collect, file, and remit sales tax within their state. These do differ state to state. A lot of states look at how many gross sales within a state. Some have set $100,000 thresholds. Some have set $200,000 thresholds. There's other states that actually look at a transaction model. So if you sell over 200 transactions into a state, you may need to get registered in that state.
Do you guys look at taxability or the way in which candy is taxed in Florida at the moment?
What do you mean? We just tax them.
The reason I ask, because there's taxability rules for products that differ state to state and sometimes differ tax jurisdiction to tax jurisdiction.
There's a number of complications when you look at candies and sweets. Prime example is in the state of Indiana, and I believe a couple of other states, they look at how candy is manufactured. So say a Snickers bar versus a Kit Kat, the Snickers would be tax exempt. The Kit Kat would be taxable. It's based on flour that was used in the manufacturing of that piece of candy. Along the same line, we look at sweets. Donuts in the state of Texas, if you order below 6 donuts, they are taxable. If you get more than 6 donuts, they're actually tax exempt.
I think you said your mom was handling the filing in Florida, but as you guys expand into these other states, you can outsource that to Avalara and we will file on your behalf into the states in which you have nexus.
Aren't there certain states that don't require nexus, they just require you charge sales tax?
50 states and then Puerto Rico, right? Because they have US sales tax. So if we look at 51, there's 5 states that don't have sales tax, and then there's probably 2 additional ones at the moment that haven't set these economic nexus thresholds. But the large majority of states have those nexus thresholds, and thus if you hit them, are required to start collecting tax. And then obviously, you know, if you're collecting, you've got to remit it back to the state.
You're probably fairly familiar, at least with tax and how sales tax works in your home state. But as you branch off into these other states, the complexity just grows, right? You may not know how the tax jurisdictions are set up. You may not know how the taxability works within that state. So that's when it's really important to look at tax automation and get some assistance on that front.
Does Avalara track if you hit nexus in any of these states?
It does. It absolutely does. And great point. No, it 100% does. So you'll have an infographic of the U.S. And let's just use North Carolina, for example. You're selling into North Carolina. When you approach 80% of that threshold, it's going to highlight in yellow. Once you get to 100%, it will highlight in orange for Avalara, notifying you that you need to get registered. Also, when you sign up for Avalara, you will get assigned what we call a customer account manager. So they'll notify you as well and say, you know, hey, Ken, we see that you hit this threshold in North Carolina. Do you want us to register on your behalf? And again, you can say, hey, account manager, please take care of that for me, or you guys can handle it on your own.
That would be great. I've never looked into what the threshold is for each state, so I wouldn't even know what to file.
So once you've automated with Avalara and you've mapped your tax codes, it is more or less sit it and forget it. We're going to monitor and maintain all of the tax rates across the US in these taxing jurisdictions.
The concern is that Ken overlooks when he's reaching nexus in a particular state. And that could result in an audit and a huge tax bill that takes his focus and resources away from growing the business. Let's get Avalara set up so that this doesn't happen. The installation is about as simple as it gets. Install the app, set up some configuration, and it's there, protecting this growing business from a potential disaster. Let's check in with Ken on his thoughts now that it's all set up and working.
How easy was it to get Avalara set up and going?
Avalara was really easy. We basically just installed it, put in the information, and let it run.
How nice is the peace of mind just knowing that even though you're not hitting those thresholds, that you've got something looking out for you to make sure, you know, you don't get well past those thresholds and end up with a huge tax problem?
It does give you peace of mind, like you said. Okay, it's nice to know that someone is out there sort of looking out for you, if you will. I would love it if one day I got a pop-up that says, hey, you hit the threshold in South Carolina or Ohio. That's good news to me, because that means we've done a lot of business there. But it's even better news knowing that I don't have to do a whole lot with it. They'll take care of it for me. And plus, that makes mom feel better. And that's really the most important part of it.
Avalara makes it easy with so many free credits until you start, you know, doing a substantial amount of orders. So for a small business like yourself, even though you're not getting all of the benefits of filing in multiple states, like, there's no reason to not do it.
That's exactly right. It's one of those things that's a no-brainer. You put it in, and you hope that someday you really need the features, but until then, you just let it ride. There's no downside to it, and that's the beauty of it. The upside is really, wow, look at how much I've done when I need it. It was a good investment, if you will.
Good investment of time.
A good time investment, exactly.
Sales tax automation takes what could be a huge burden for a small business and makes it a simple process. Now that we've taken that worry out of Ken's mind, we can get back to focusing on growth initiatives. In our next video that you can click here to watch, we're going to start building a loyalty and review strategy. Be sure to click over here to go to ecommercemakeover.com to download our playbook on how we're growing Bulk Candy Store and to receive special offers on all the tools we'll be using. And of course, subscribe so that you'll be notified each time we release new episodes.